My 7-year-old brother slept with all my friends. Hi, my name is Allison, and I'd like to tell you about my little 7-year-old brother and how he slept with all my friends. This might sound a bit cocky, but I'm one of the richest students in my school. Now, I'm not telling you this because I want to impress anyone, but so you understand my circumstances. You see, with money comes popularity. Everyone wants to be your friend. That's exactly what happened to me. Whenever I threw a party, all the students in my class wanted to attend. For my birthday party, I decided I wanted to do something a bit more intimate, but still amazing and fun. I threw a slumber party for all my female friends. Now, this wasn't your regular slumber party. I don't do anything halfway. My parents spared no expense to make this the best night for me and my friends. Popcorn machines were ordered, the decorations looked amazing all over our living room, and we hired a catering company to offer us girls all kinds of options for dinner. Daddy told me, "I blew about $20,000 just to make this memorable. You're my princess and I'll always spoil you." So my birthday is a really big deal to him. My dad is a big real estate mogul, and my mom works as his main accountant. They are partners in both love and business, and they are amazing together. When I grow up, I want to find a man who can keep up with me, like Dad does with Mom. They love to travel, so I always have the house to myself. And of course, there's my bratty little brother. His name is Nathan, and though I really love him, he can be so annoying. Nathan is young, but he thinks he's a mini version of my dad. You know, the super cool guy. All my friends think he is adorable, but I think he's super annoying. And he is way too smart for his own good. He walks around the house as if he's a 21-year-old living a bachelor's life. The kid's 7, and whenever my mom and dad left for their trips, I had to keep an eye on the little brat. Now, I'm not a monster. I'm not just going to abandon my baby brother. So no matter what event I organized, I always took care of him, even during my slumber party. So the day of my birthday arrived, and all my friends were having an amazing time. All of a sudden, Nathan arrived, introducing himself to all the girls. He said, "Hey ladies, welcome to my bachelor pad. Drinks and assortments are near the kitchen. Don't be afraid to give me a ring." You know what the little rascal asked them to call him? Nathan the Salt Shaker. Why, you might ask? Because he likes to bring flavor wherever he goes. I wanted to kill my baby brother. I even caught him in the bathroom using Dad's $200 Versace cologne all over his body and applying aftershave to his face. Well, I gotta admit, the kid can be hilarious. He doesn't even have fuzz on his face, cute little thing. But I intervened anyway. "Hey Nathan, get out of there!"
"Come on, sis, let me get ready. I have company over. They are going to need me at my finest."
"You should really head to bed," I said. So here we are, watching movies and enjoying our dinner, when I noticed Nathan was nowhere to be seen. I got worried. Honestly, since our mansion is huge, there are so many bedrooms and over 6 bathrooms. Not to speak of the study, the library, the gardens, the stables, and even the winter garden. Mom once told me, "We purchased this house for over $6 million and then just continued to improve it until it was just right. I couldn't bear to see the finishes in this home." Isn't that insane? I searched for Nathan all over and began to panic a little. I tried to calm myself down, thinking he was probably just hiding to mess with me. After all, he couldn't have gone far, right? Eventually, I sat back down and tried to relax. I was so exhausted that I ended up dozing off till morning. Do you know what I woke up to? My baby brother dressed in a robe, in bed with all my friends. Yes, I'm not even kidding you. I wish I was. He managed to get there without anyone noticing after the girls fell asleep. Since he was so small, he didn't wake anyone up. I wanted to kill the little rascal. I admit that I was a bit worried because some of the girls' nightwear is a bit revealing. Nothing major, you know. Nathan's just 7. I didn't want him seeing anything he shouldn't. When my friends woke up, they all found it hilarious. They called Nathan their knight in shining armor, telling him he had protected them from the monsters all through the night. He admitted that he had hidden, so I wouldn't realize he was planning to sleep in the same bed with all my friends. The next day, school was hell for me. Everyone knew what my little brother did. I found it embarrassing, but mostly because now it really is going to get to his head. He believes he's a little Casanova and won't shut up about it. Goodness, I don't know how I'll be able to stand to be around him now. What's worse, Mom and Dad laughed for minutes when I told them about it. Nathan is too adorable to be scolded. Thanks for watching. Have you ever been embarrassed by your sibling? Let us know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe and check out other videos on our channel.